What's up, guys? I'm Ben from AuthenTech, and I just got home from CES Vegas, and then I went over to California for a little bit. If you're following me on my Instagram, I post all my behind-the-scenes shots there, so make sure you're following me. It feels really good to be back home. So my last big video was on the Insta360 One S, and I showed a little bit of my workflow in the app, but I also mentioned that sometimes I'll edit these files in my Final Cut workflow. I asked you guys if you wanted to see a little bit of that Final Cut workflow, and a lot of you said yes. Gary said yes, definitely Final Cut video. I just got the camera and haven't tried it in Final Cut yet. Next Level says for best quality stitch on the computer and then edit in Final Cut. It's less convenient, but you'll see the difference. I'm not sure about that, but I guess we'll soon find out if the quality is better while editing in Final Cut. Oh, Chris says, keep making instructional videos. Thank you, sir. I definitely would love to if you guys wanna see more. So let me know what you wanna see and I'll work on them. Thomas, great video. Show us your Final Cut 10 workflow, please. Definitely, thank you. Joe, I'd like to see the workflow in Final Cut. Perfect. A Diver Dave asked for it. Poco, Guido, Image Buff. So that's plenty of people asking for it. Let's jump over to the computer and let me show you the workflow.
All right, so we're jumping over to my iMac 5K. First step is to go to the Insta360 website, go to their downloads page. We're gonna be using the One X today, of course. Go to the downloads. Up top, you can see the Android and iOS app. Here's your latest firmware downloads. And then here's the studio app, and we can see that it's in beta. So that's sort of the problem. We're kind of doing a workaround here. There's no plug-in for Final Cut directly yet, but I'm waiting for it, and I have some high hopes for some cool features. We have the studio app for Windows or Mac, so we download that for Mac. I already have it loaded on here. Next, we're gonna eject the SIM card from the Insta360 camera, which this thing is always a pain to get out. Okay, are you serious? Okay, I can't even get it with my finger. This is not good. All right, we grabbed a little SIM tool to eject the micro SD card from the camera. We're gonna copy over a few clips I shot over in Oceanside. You'll see .insps and .insv files. Those are the Insta photo and video file types. All right, let's just copy and paste those five over. Okay. Now real quick, if we go over to last year's One camera and scroll down, we can see there is a plugin for Adobe Premiere. Now that's great for any of you using Premiere, but I am in Final Cut, so I can't wait for the Final Cut plugin to come out, hopefully soon. All right, those files are copied over. We're gonna launch the Studio One X beta app, drag these over to here. And what's nice is we can drag in multiple files at once. Nice, look at that attractive shot. We can scrub through the clips here. We can set our ins and outs, which is nice. So I'm using the e-rectangular viewer here, and we're basically gonna select our clips and hit batch export. Now I like to do target resolution original, original highest resolution bitrate, turn on flow state stabilization, turn off lock direction and watermark, destination directory. We're gonna put it in the sample clips here. Open and okay. It's nice, we can watch the status of the export. Let's go ahead and do a little fast forward magic here. What's nice is there's a progress bar so we can watch the live status of the exporting. But as you can tell, we started at 12:12. We're at 12:23 now, so it's taken over 10 minutes just for two clips. Now, my computer isn't the fastest in the world, but this is sort of a cumbersome workaround. We're basically taking these wide spherical 360 files that only Insta can read, and until that Final Cut plugin is released, we have to export these into a flat image per se, so that we can then bring them into Final Cut, so that it can think it's a 360 file, so we can reposition the camera angle. It's sort of a silly workaround, but that's kind of what we're stuck with right now. And one last note I wanna add, if you see the dimensions of this export video, it's 5760 by 2880. So that's where the 5.7K video resolution comes from. Now that's way better than 4K, which is awesome, but that's spread across a full spherical image. So by the time we crop or zoom in, we're left with less than 4K pixels on that 16:9 cropped in image, if that makes sense. All right, and that second clip is almost finished. 99. There it is, finally exported. That took a little while. So what did I say? We started at 12:12. two little video clips, one 52 seconds, the other is a minute 39. So what is that? Took about 15 minutes to export just those two clips. Not great. So now we can close that app and open Final Cut because we have these two .mp4 files that it can read well. So I have my project array created. We're going to drag these two clips, bring them into Final Cut, and there we go. By this nice little icon, it can tell it's a 360 spherical clip. Also up here in this new viewer, we can do 360 viewer, and then you can see a preview of your cropped in shot and then the full wide spherical. I usually turn that off, select the clip, E to drop it down to timeline, Shift Z to fill the space. I like to hit Control V so we can look at our keyframes that we're about to create. And this is where the magic is. Under orientation, we have our X, Y, and Z axis to rotate and tilt around. Also your field of view. We can zoom in or way out. And you can start to see that there's a lot of black areas. So that black space is removed right around 133 if you want super wide angle. And then this is how we do some keyframes. So let's find our move. Right here, option left bracket. We're gonna turn on these keyframes here, hit play. Let's see if the poor computer can handle it. Boom, I swung under the pier here. All right, this would be a good time to rotate the camera, pan over to the right. Tilt down a little bit. You can even zoom in just a little. And you can see the keyframes are created right there. So then if we hit play, it will automatically rotate, pan, tilt, etc. between those two keyframes that you set. And that's the gist of it. From there, as the clip continues, we can move the camera in different directions, pan around, tilt up. You can see the new keyframes are created there. All right, I swing it up. Let's tilt camera down, pan back over right. Control R to render that out. Again, my poor machine is recording a massive 4 or 5K resolution on the second monitor, so everything is running a little bit slower than normal. Let's see if playback is a little bit smoother. There we go. It's panning and tilting between the two keyframes set. Oh, one side note, I don't believe that there's a way to modify the handles on these keyframes. Sort of a bummer. If you know of a way, let me know down in the comments. Boom, 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 boom. And so that's basically it, setting keyframes between your three access points and field of view. And that's one way of editing these files in Final Cut. Now I've said it before, their mobile app is actually really good. And that's how I edit most of my Insta360 clips for both socials and 16:9 YouTube clips. And there you guys have it, a quick little workflow tutorial on one way of editing those Insta360 clips in Final Cut Pro 10.
Thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope that was helpful. Let me know if you want to see any other tutorials down in the comments. I enjoy making these and would love to work on more. Now, if you're new around here, hit that subscribe button so you can stay up to date on all my future tech videos. And I'll give you all the links to my other video reviews and product links down in the description. Until next time, let's live AuthenTech.